This will be a short demo of wireless Bluetooth headphones. These are Moxpad X90. I bought them from Banggood. These are in black, but you can also get them in transparent blue. They support Bluetooth 4.1, and the best thing about them is that the battery and Bluetooth unit is housed in the controller. This means that the earphones are light and slim in design. This is something I wanted, since I'm using them under the helmet, and I wanted the headphones to be as slim as possible. And this was not an easy task, since most of the wireless headphones on the market today are really bulky, because they usually insert the battery into the earphones. There is also the benefit, when you remove the Bluetooth radio waves away from your head, when you have the transmitter in the controller housing. These came with three different tips. There was also a micro USB cable included in the box, but as you can see, I changed tips to memory foam tips. I prefer memory foam, since they fit better in the ear, and also seal better from the outside noise. These fit nicely into the ears, and there are no hard edges that could hurt your ears. The headphones have double dynamic drivers. This means you get a dedicated subwoofer and crossover, so each driver reproduces a different part of the frequency spectrum, which ensures your bass kicks hard while the rest of the spectrum remains clean and clear. I can't really say that it makes a difference, since I mostly listen to podcasts. Yes, even Siri likes podcasts. What do you think I do when I have some time to kill? Just kidding. But when I try some music, they seem to produce more bass than other headphones I have. These are also quite loud, even at low volume. You can also hear a little of white noise when no music is playing, but the noise stops after a few seconds. You can't really hear it when the music is playing. It's just something I notice when I pause. The controls are simple. You hold the middle button to power on and off the headphones. You get voice prompts when you power on or off the headphones, and you also get a voice prompt when the headphones connect to your phone. The prompts were in Chinese when I got them, but you can change to English. Just press twice on the middle button to change the language, but be aware that you are disconnected from your phone if you want to change the language, because if you press twice on the middle button, it will start a call to your last phone number, and it won't change the language. This is a feature you can use to call the last phone number you dialed. So make sure you are disconnected from your phone when you want to change the language. I forgot to mention this tube that is around the cable. You can shape this to guide the cable around your ear. It's quite flexible and retains its shape, so you can really mold it to your liking. If we look at the controller, it has the volume controls and answer button. You can also use volume buttons to skip or rewind tracks. There is a small LED that shows the status of headphones, and an built-in microphone for your phone functions, and you charge the headphones with a micro USB port on the side. To pair the headphones, just keep holding the middle button. They charge in around 2 hours from completely empty to full. The battery lasts around 3 hours. The headphones connect really fast to the phone. They connect as soon as you turn them on. I must say I really like them, so go and check them out. I will leave the link to the headphones in the comments. Like if you enjoyed this video, leave your comments, and thanks for watching. Bye.